Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this email productivity guide for Gmail for entrepreneurs, you're going to learn 7 actionable tips you can use to transform your inbox into a business growth asset as opposed to a productivity nightmare and headache. Timestamp table of contents in the description, along with some other helpful videos that walk you through how we stay organized with our files and our project manager. So the very first tip I have for you deals with how you actually look at email, and that is to time block when you're going to check your inbox. I highly recommend time blocking 2 or 3 times throughout the day, no more than an hour each, where you're going to be in your inbox. And this does 2 very important things. Number one, it makes sure that you stay on track with everything else because it's so easy to read an email and allow it to derail your entire day. So this way, you're planning and setting intention when you're going to open your inbox. And that way, the rest of the day, you can rest easy. You don't have to worry about, oh no, is another email coming in? Because you know ahead of time that you're going to check your inbox. The second big advantage is that it trains everybody else around you that you aren't on call 24/7. In this day and age where it feels like there's always something happening, you need time as an entrepreneur, business owner to actually get work done. And so the less time you can spend in your inbox, the more time you have to spend on things that are actually important. And the more you follow the system, people will get used to. It'll be rough at the beginning, but people in your life will get used to the fact that you take 24 to 48 hours to reply. Now, I'll go through some other tips for the people who actually need faster, you know, turnaround times from you, but your inbox is not for that. Now, the second tip I have for you is and that is having 2 email accounts, because probably 80 to 90% of the emails that you get, and I can't believe I'm saying this as a marketer, but most of those are from robots, right? They're not from actual people. They're some sort of automated sequence designed to just tell you about some products or services. And most of those emails are just coming at random times. And the problem is whatever problems you're facing aren't necessarily lined up with the information that's in those emails. So most of those emails wind up being a distraction. So what I've actually done is I have 1 email for my actual work, and then I have another email where I sign up to all those different email lists for their free offers or getting the newsletters. And that way they're completely separate. So when I'm in my inbox for work and looking at things, I'm not going to be distracted with all of those marketing messages and automated robot emails. Now there is a little asterisk here. There are a couple of influencers that I like actually reading their emails. So I actually have 5 that I allow in my actual inbox, and I don't auto archive or put in another account. So I recommend having no more than 5 of those types of emails or newsletters that you actually enjoy reading, and the rest just send them to auto archive or go ahead and set up a second account. Now the third tip I have for you deals with when you're actually in your time block and you're starting to look at all of those emails. And that is the first 5 minutes, simply scan. Don't reply to anything, don't take any actions, simply scan and take an inventory of everything that's in your inbox, because this is going to help you stay organized and prioritized with the next couple of steps. And so the reason that you want to do this is it's really easy to see an email and then jump into it and start working on it and fixing it, and then your hour's up, and then you see another email that was actually a little more important. So spend the first 5 minutes organizing, auto archiving, and labeling. Something that I really like doing is I have a label. I know it's OCD, but I have a label for every single message that comes into my inbox. And the reason that this is so important is I can quickly read a message and go, oh, okay. And then when I click archive, if I ever have to go find that message again, I know exactly what folder it's in. So once you've done that 5 to 10 minutes of scanning and organizing and archiving, hopefully you only have emails that you actually have to take action on left. And so with those, you want to prioritize. Now these are going to be my priorities. Of course, you can come up with your own list, but I recommend having a list of 3 to 5 clear priorities. So when you go into your inbox, you know for a fact, if there was only 1 set of emails that you could get to, those are the ones you'd absolutely have to get to, and you don't touch any other emails until those are done. So for me, the first one are administrative updates, bills due, subscriptions expiring, broken stuff with our software, right? So those are the ones that I look at and fix first. And then and only then do I go to my second priority, which is going to be clients. So I look for, is anyone happy? Is anything broken? And then once all the clients are happy or I've done something else, which I'll get to in a moment, then I go ahead and look at our inbound emails, and these are our sales emails for getting new clients. And so those are my three priorities. And once that scan is done and I've gone through these priorities, then if anything else is left over and I still have time in my time block, I'll look at it. If I don't have any time in my time block left, or I haven't gone through all my priorities yet, then those other emails just fall by the wayside. And I can tell you, sometimes it'll feel like things are piling up, but life will go on. Your business will keep growing. And because you're focused on your 3 to 5 priorities, you'll quickly notice how emails that used to seem really important actually wind up not being important, and you can just let them go. Now, tip number 5 when you're going through your priorities is following the 2-minute rule. And so if you cannot respond or take care of the email in under 2 minutes, then it should become an actual task. And so what I do for all of those administrative emails, a bill or a subscription expiring, if I can't quickly log in and pay for something, or if it's a broken piece of software and I have to talk to somebody else on my team, what I'll do is I'll take that email and I will forward it to our project manager. Now, we used to use Asana and I would just forward things directly to Asana. We now use Basecamp and you can do the same. It doesn't really matter what project manager you're using, but if it's gonna take more than 2 minutes, then it should actually be a task or a project as opposed to something you're just checking out in your email. And this is what's really going to help you keep your email time down, because then once it's in your project manager, you can go ahead and archive that email and it's in the right place, because now it's on your to-do list. And then when you're doing your project planning and all that other fun stuff, then you decide whether or not it's important. So this way you make sure that if something's going to take more than 2 minutes, it should be moved to a completely different place, because you may have something on your task list that's actually way more important than this email that's gonna take more than 2 minutes. But an easy trap to fall into is because you're in your inbox, you're in reaction mode, you immediately react, right? Even though you shouldn't be immediately reacting. So that's why you wanna push those off. And then those messages that are going to take a really long time, like if the message is gonna take a really, really long time, then I go ahead and forward that to my task manager and say, I need to reply to this person and set the due date, you know, for a day or two. And the reason that the system works is because it forces you to really be intentional with the emails that you're spending time on, because it's so easy to just go into autopilot mode and just check every single email, reply to every single email, act on every single email. And that's not the way you don't want your inbox controlling how you're spending your time. Now, the second to last tip I have for you, number 6, is going to be team. And that is moving all of your team communication out of email immediately. Up until recently, 95% of our team communication was done inside of our project manager. Thanks to moving to Basecamp, we have a feature called Pings, which allows us to privately chat with each other. And so 100% of our team communication is inside of Basecamp. What this allows you to do as a business owner or entrepreneur is when you're checking in on communications, you can go to your project manager and know that when you're in your project manager, those are the people that actually need to hear from you in less than 24 hours. And then you can actually have communication with your team and collaborators without all of the clutter of mess of whatever's in your inbox. Now, the last tip I have for you, tip number 7, I kind of gave it away already, but that is labeling like no other. Like, seriously, start labeling everything. What's really great about labeling is it allows you to quickly see during your scan what emails are new, and it also helps you with spam, like helps you with spam a lot. So when I'm doing my scan, when I'm doing my first time block of email checking, and I see an email that doesn't have a tag, then I can immediately make the decision as, is this a new sales lead? Is this a new client? Is this a new person that I should actually be talking to? Or is it some spam and someone's, you know, sold my email someplace and I just need to delete it and move on with my day? And so when you start labeling everything, your scan process becomes quicker and quicker and quicker. And it also allows you not to read a lot of different emails, because when you get those administrative emails or those marketing messages and you don't really have time to read them, you can just click auto archive. And then later on, if you want to go back and read them or you need that information for something in the future, you can go to that specific folder. It's going to save you a tremendous amount of time. So thank you so much for watching and sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. And most importantly, you can be a little more productive with your inbox and it become less of a headache and a driver of your to-do list, so you can be more intentional with your inbox and hopefully eventually one day reach inbox zero. Maybe, I don't know, it's a tall order, I know, but maybe one day we can all enjoy inbox zero. So go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe for more productivity videos for entrepreneurs just like this one. And until the next, keep building the business you love.